Obviously, we will see the importance of reading, and I will share with you some recommended reading techniques. Actually, reading improves your memory power, it boosts your creativity, it helps you discover new things, and it makes you a good speaker. Here are some recommended reading techniques. We have scanning, skimming, active reading, detailed reading, structure, proposition, evaluation, and survey, question, read, recite, and review. Scanning is a reading strategy that is used for getting some specific points by looking at the whole text. Skimming is used for getting the gist of the whole text lead. Active reading aims to get an in-depth understanding of the text. Detailed reading is used for extracting information accurately from the whole text. Speed reading basically aims to increase the reading speed without compromising the understanding of the text reading. Structure proposition evaluation is the best way to read a book is to find the structure, author made propositions, and to create your own evaluations. And for the survey questions, read, recite, review, the goal is to get you closer to full comprehension of the text. Scanning is reading a text quickly in order to find specific information like figures or name. Learner taking a reading test needs to scan a text or population rates quickly to find out if a series of statements about the population figures are true or false. When scanning, there are some tips that you should use, like don't start from the beginning and read to the end. Jump around in the information you need. Don't read every word and look for information as quickly as you can. Skimming is reading a text quickly to get a general idea of meaning, and the learner taking a reading exam decides to approach text by looking at the title, introductions, and any diagrams and subheadings, then skim reading to get a clear general idea of what the text is about. Actually, there is a difference between scanning and skimming. Like in scanning, we have phone directory when you want to see a show, and the reading technique is used when you want to locate a single fact or specific bit of information without reading every word, and it's a fast way to find info, and you must be accurate in terms of finding a specific TV show or phone, and it's often done with material that you know something about. For skimming, it's a fast reading, and you get the main idea, not all the details. You must leave out parts. You may leave out half or third paragraph once you have the main idea of the paragraph, and comprehension is lower. Just try to comprehend as much as you can while reading at an average speed, so you understand 50% of what you are reading, and twice as least, and it's usually done with material you know nothing about. So note, as speed increases, comprehension decreases. We have active reading, so the objective is to identify new words, find the main idea or thesis, create a preliminary outline, read with a pencil, draw and scratch, also make a shrinking outline, and read again and again. Detailed reading. So this technique is used for extracting information accurately from the whole text. And under this technique, we read every word for understanding the meaning of the text. And in this careful reading, we can skim the text first for getting a general idea, and then go back to reading detail. Speed reading. So the aim of speed reading is basically to increase the reading speed without compromising the understanding of the text reading. And actually, there are some strategies that you should take into consideration in speed reading, like identifying the words without focusing on each letter, not to sounding out all the words, not sub-vocalizing some phrases, spending less time on some phrases than others, and also skimming small sections. For structure proposition evaluation, it is mainly applicable to non-fiction writing, and this technique suggests reading as per the three following patterns, like studying the structure of the work, studying the logical propositions made and organized into chains of inference, and also evaluation of the merits of the arguments and conclusions. We have the survey, question, read, recite, and review. So this includes five different steps. As stated for the survey, it involves getting a quick idea of the whole writing piece. For the question, we are not just reading the words or looking at the words, but we are actually trying to make out the underlying meaning of the text. So we should prepare questions in our mind and look for the answers while reading the text. So the reader should read selectively if they are looking for any specific. Recite, so the reader should answer the questions in his own words, using only the keywords that are required to sum up the completed idea. And review, so the reader should review the entire things in his mind. To conclude, reading is a good exercise for the mind, and it helps people calm down and relax, opening doors of new knowledge to enlighten their minds. And it's a way to develop your vocabulary, and it's necessary for success.